I was leaving home and going to hell about as fast as I could go. Mostly just alcohol, and there was a lot of it. And but also another thing that raised its ugly head in there was what turned out to be later was a sexual addiction. My marriage was never really a good one, never a really strong one. I was always a lot of infidelity going on, a lot of secrets, a lot of lies. And it seemed like it was lies layered upon lies. I got to be what I thought to be probably a pretty good dentist. I had a pretty good practice, I know that. About 13 years, and 13 years into my dentistry, I was in a meeting in Nashville at a seminar, and got up Sunday morning to go home early, and we shut down the bars that night in Nashville at the Cattlemen's Restaurant, as I remember. And I remember getting up that morning and walking to the bathroom, and I fell down and immediately jumped back up. And when I jumped back up, I kind of shook my head and thought, this is the most hellacious hangover I've ever had. And finally started breaking out in sweat, fell into the floor, and the floor was a tile floor, and I couldn't even get any traction, couldn't move on, and kind of slide around on it. Finally got my foot against the base of the toilet and was able to get myself pulled out in the room with my right arm. My left side was not working at that time. And I pulled myself over the telephone. My brother was a neurosurgeon in Johnson City. He answered the phone, and I got on there and said, Burr, you know, it's left leg, my left side not working, and I slurred. He said, just to lie real still, you're bleeding to death inside your head right now. You're having a stroke. And they got me in the ambulance. I still didn't pass out. And remember going all the way to the ambulance to the hospital. They got me in this little, I guess it's an emergency room, and I remember this white curtain around me. It was just everything bright white and exquisite pain. My head was just really, really hurting. And somewhere in the afternoon, my brother had gotten there. He took a private plane and flew over there to be with me. I remember talking to him and saying that, how am I going to be? And he said, well, I don't think I'm going to run any more foot races. And that's true, I haven't. And that was 29 years ago. I was 39 years old at the time. And I'd been practicing dentistry at that time about 13 years. And I was left-handed. And left-handed dentist without a use of a left hand, not too good. So I went through that process of having to give up my dental practice, sell it, and going through brain surgery to repair the damage that had been done in my brain from this stroke. Gone through the divorce, and I soon had met my wife, soon-to-be wife. So my girlfriend at the time and I were up on my houseboat that I was living on. I bought a 52-foot steel-hulled houseboat, an old Starduster, and it was a jungle gym for me. I mean, it helped me a lot with my rehab, and everybody was scared when they saw me coming into the dock because I had driving that 52-footer with one hand and one leg. My former hygienist had worked through me for about 12 of my 13 years of practice. And she's someone I know that had been praying for me for all those years. She came up there at the houseboat and with her husband. I said, Bill, what you up to? He said, well, I'm taking a course at church now, teaching people how to share the gospel. I said, the gospel? What do you mean the gospel? He said, the good news of Jesus Christ. I said, what do you mean the good news of Jesus Christ? Bill said, the only thing you have to do is pray and accept Jesus into your life. And I said, I don't know how to pray. And Bill said, I can just say a little prayer for you, and if you repeat it back to me and really mean it in your heart, you can ask Jesus into your life. And I said, I want to. He said, just do it a few words, two or three words at a time, because I have a short-term memory loss with my stroke, and I can't hold too many words in my mind, so just do a few words. He started out with, and he said, Dear Lord, and I said, Dear Lord, and I've been body slammed into the kingdom of light. And my life was forever changed, and that's the dividing line, the watershed of my life. Those two lives, I got the BC life and the AD life, that before Christ and then after Christ, and it's so dramatically different, it makes me shake my head every time I look at it. And now then, I've been a one-woman man now for 30 years, with no infidelity and no desire for it. Jesus took that desire away from me, and cured that addiction, if you will, and I'm so thankful for it. That's probably the greatest blessing of my Christian life, is to be able to walk into marriage. My dream was always to want to come home to a wife. And I've had it now for 30 years.
How great the love of Jesus Christ. Cross of Calvary, the blood was shed that pardons me. No longer bound.